Hello dear students, welcome to another video lecture session of botany second year semester third topic meristematic tissues. Today we will discuss about meristematic tissues and its functions also. First, every organism made up of with a single cell or many cells. Most of the biologists are developed some characteristics or qualities and traits to distinguish from living things to non-living things. One of the key characteristics of living organism is growth and development process. Growth is a complex process which is simultaneously coordinated with development also. Growth and development takes place normally in the cells only. Every living organism should start its life with a single diploid cell that is known as zygote. Zygote gradually undergo some mitotic divisions. It gives diploid group of cells is known as embryo. In the embryonic stage, the cells are differentiated and it produced organs or organ related systems. Then it make an adult plant. How the plants are, a small sapling develops into a big plant or a tree. How it is possible? So behind this secrecy, you know very well, one of the important tissue is there in the plants. In the plants, tissues are broadly classified into two types. One is meristematic tissues, another one is permanent tissues. Now let us talk about meristematic tissues. So what are meristems? So in the embryonic stage or in the plant body, a group of an undifferentiated mass of cells present and performing a specific function that is known as growth. That is called as meristems. These meristem cells composed of an undifferentiated mass of cells. These cells are young and immature always. They are always active and young, and moreover, it produces different type of permanent tissues in the plant body. These cells rapidly undergo mitotic divisions in growing regions of the plant, and they give rise to various plant organs like stem or different type of buds, leaves, and other reproductive organs. Also, many main function of meristem tissue is to assist in plant growth. How the plant vertically grow. Moreover, in case of animals, the growth process is limited. It is restricted to a certain age only. But in case of plant, lifelong, it continuous process. This growth carried out by a group of undifferentiated young active cells known as meristems. This term meristem was first proposed by Carl Nageli. That means it divided. Are rapidly it divide and it gives number of cells. What are the characteristics of meristematic cells? These cells normally located at a growing apex of plant pods. Growing apex of plant pods means the apical part of the shoot, the apical part of the root or root tip, or sometimes lateral. Meristematic tissue present in the axillary bud, which leads to formation of a leaf also. These cells are undifferentiated, and the shape of cells more or less isodiametric, sometimes circular, maybe polygonal also. These cells having a cell wall, a thin cell wall. It's made up of cellulose only. There is no secondary cell wall structure. So cell wall composed of primary wall only, that is cellulose wall only, very thin it is. And no intercellular spaces, because all the cells are isodiametric or polygonal. That's why all cells are together. There is no gaps between the cells. And inside the cell, dense abundant granular cytoplasm is there, and a prominent diploid nucleus, and without any nitrogenous wastage substances or no ergastic substances present in the cells. And in the cytoplasm, we can see proplastids are present. These proplastids are derived as three kinds of plastids in coming soon. Cells contain more ribosomes and mitochondria, because these cells are very active tissue. They always undergo cell division process. It requires more amount of energy. That's why the number of mitochondria is also huge in case of meristems, because it requires more amount of energy to do cell division process. Cells do not store reserve food material, no reserve food material in the cell. And these cells are metabolically more active. And these meristematic cells are usually lack of virus particles. That's why in the tissue culture process, meristem culture used for the production of virus-free plant are obtained from the meristem tissue taken as a explant. So this is about the characteristics of meristematic cells. These meristematic cells are polygonal shape, prominent nucleus are there, cytoplasm is there, thin cell wall, there is no cellular spaces between them. So based on the diagram, we can easily describe the tissue characters. Next, furtherly, we discuss about classification of meristems. These meristem tissues are classified into number of ways. Based on origin, there are three types actually. That is called protomeristem, primary meristem, secondary meristem. Based on function, protoderm, procambium, ground meristem. Based on position, apical meristem, intercalary meristem. Third one is lateral meristem. Based on plane of division also, meristems are classified into three types: mass meristem, plate meristem, and rib meristem. So this is the plane of division, how the cells undergo division process, on which plane the cell divided and it gives the new daughter cells. And based on position, where it is present, the meristematic tissue present in the plant body, the location of the meristem, based on that apical, intercalary, and lateral. So this is apical, this is the intercalary, these are the lateral meristems are there. And based on function, at the secondary growth or during the normal growth also. And based on origin, how these meristem cells are derived from the embryo. So based on that also, we can classify the meristems into number of ways. So first we can go for the meristems are classified based on the position. Based on the position of the meristematic tissue in the plant body. During the embryonic development, few meristematic cells are migrated into the certain parts of the plant. They always retained and they continue the divisional process, helps in the growth. So these apical means it indicates top apex region. Generally, apical meristem occurs at the tips of stem, roots, and leaves. These meristem cells composed one or more cells. Mostly they are present in the growing tips. Growing tip means shoot tip or root tip. Also called as apical cell or apical initial. One of the cell always placed on the top position, they called as apical cell or apical initial. These cells maintain their individuality and position. They always maintain their individuality and the position constantly. Activity of this meristem cause increase in the length. So how the stem length day by day increases. After 1 month of the sapling, just you can observe the length of the shoot increases from 3 meters to 3.5 meters. How it is possible? By the help of apical meristem only, we can say that. So produces the primary structure of the plants. It produces primary structures of the plants. Apical meristem is terminal in stem and subterminal in roots. Apical meristem in case of shoot system, it is always in the terminal position. But in case of roots, it is subterminal, it below the root cap, because root always penetrate into the soil. Soil is the oddest rocky substance. That's why the root tip protected by the root cap only. So below the root cap, you can see apical meristem in the roots. That's why it is subterminal in roots. Number of apical cell varies in different plant groups based on the number of cells present in the apical meristem. So it is different from one plant to another plant group. Mostly lower plants usually have single apical cells, but in case of gymnosperms and angiosperms have a group of cells always together. They present in the shoot apex and root apex and helps in the growth process. So this is apical meristem. See here, this is the shoot apex. This is called as apical meristem is always present in the top position. Next one is lateral meristem. Lateral meristem means which present parallel to the organs in which they occupy. Helps in increasing in diameter of the plant body. How the diameter of the plant, that means this is diameter. So diameter is gradually increases. The lateral meristem play an important role in the secondary growth process. In the secondary growth is nothing but after completion of the primary growth, the shoot system or root system of the plant increase in the breadth, increase in the diameter or radius of the shoot or root of the particular plant. So they divide only in one plane, that is periclinal plane. So periclinal plane, so they divide and it gives number of rows of the cells, newly formed number of cells which are arranged in different rows. Example is one of the vascular cambium which comes under lateral meristem. So example is intravascular cambium is an example for lateral meristem. And after secondary growth, we can say phellogen or cord cambium is also comes under lateral meristem. So lateral meristem helps in the secondary growth process and increase the diameter of the plant by adding new cells to the existing ones. Already number of tissues are present in the plant body. In addition to that, new cells are formed by the action of lateral meristem. Third one is intercalary meristem. Intercalary meristem is present between the permanent tissues. Sometimes what happened, a little amount of the meristematic tissue placed in between the permanent tissues. They are actively growing region behind apical meristem. They are not typical meristems. Unusually observed in few group of plants, commonly found in internodes of vascular plants and also in leaf sheath of grasses and present just above the node of equisetum. For example, in the monocots, the node part comparatively internodal part, comparatively internodal part, the node part become bulged because due to the presence of intercalary meristems. Intercalary meristem cells also undergo few divisions, and it increase the length nearer the nodal region only, because there is no space already, it filled with permanent tissues. So that's why a little growth takes place in the nodal region, it becomes bulged. So these are the nodes, these are the internodal region. They are the portion of apical meristem that were separated from the apex during the development by layers of differentiated tissues. Because the meristem tissue always, they give permanent tissues, and as well as they maintain its individuality also. Next, based on the development, meristems are classified into three types: promeristem, primary meristem, and secondary meristem. Pro means initial. During the embryogenesis, early embryonic meristem from which other advanced meristems are derived. That means in the embryonic stage, whatever the cells which are responsible for the development of two type of meristems. So their function is to produce the cells of the primary meristem. The promeristems it derives, it gives primary meristems. So the embryonic cells, it is composed with initials. These initial cells converted into primary meristems. In plants, it occupy a small area at the tip of stem and root. Continuous division is the characteristics of initials. It divide further to form primary meristem. So in case of shoot apex or root apex, one of the apical initial cell is there. That initial cell divide and it gives primary meristem. So best example for primary meristems are shoot and root apex meristems comes under primary meristems only. The apical meristems is nothing but primary meristems only. It is composed of initials. These initial cells divide furtherly to form primary meristems. So next, second one is primary meristems. They are derived from embryonic cells, continuously involved in cell division and growth. Apical meristems are best example for primary meristems. So always they divide and it gives new cells or permanent tissues. They are settled down below the root apex and as well as above the root apex. So apical meristems, both apical meristems are best example for primary meristems. So next, secondary meristem. Secondary meristems are developed from permanent tissues. Secondary meristems are developed from permanent tissues. So permanent tissues means due to lack of divisionable capacity. Due to lack of divisionable capacity in the permanent tissues. These permanent tissues which are de-differentiated and it's converted or differentiated into meristematic cells. These meristematic cells are placed parallel to the axis, parallel to the main axis. So best example is interfascicular cambium and phellogen or cork cambium belongs to secondary meristems. By these secondary meristematic tissues, the root and stem and the branches, they grow in radial manner. They grow in radial manner. So these meristems are developed from the permanent tissues. So primary meristems are derived from embryonic cells, but secondary meristems are derived from permanent tissues. In the permanent tissues, they are lacking in the divisionable capacity, but they are undergo de-differentiation process and they regain the divisionable capacity and converted into meristematic tissues. Such meristems are called as secondary meristems. These secondary meristems are helps in the increase in the radial thickness of the shoot or root. Best example is corp cambium, and another reason is interfascicular cambium also. Next, third type of classification of meristems based on plane of division. So, according to the plane of division, meristems are classified into three types: mass meristem, rib meristem, plate meristem. Mass meristem means in any group of meristematic cells, they undergo divisions in all planes, in all directions. Example is endosperm, young embryo, and sporangium. For example, in the sporangium, we can go for the microsporangium, how the microspores are developed by different type of divisions takes place. So in all type of divisions, and takes in all planes, it gives a mass of cells. So that's why it is called as mass meristems. So this type of growth observed in embryo, endosperm, and pit region and sporangium. Second one is rib meristem. Sometimes it is called thigh meristem also. It divides anticlinally in one plane. So what type of divisions takes place? Anticlinal divisions. Periclinal divisions, by the resulting of periclinal divisions, the cells are arranged in parallel rows. That's why the cortex and pith region increases. Development of the cortex, normally in the cortex is a multi-layer structure. The cells are arranged in multi-layers. So that's why periclinal divisions are responsible for the arrangement of cells in number of rows. Plate meristem, third type is plate meristem. Plate meristem means in these cells, mostly anticlinal divisions are taking place. Anticlinal divisions are in these, it divides anticlinally in two planes. One is transverse, another one is vertical. Vertical division as well as transverse division. Both type of divisions are taking place. So example is development of epidermis. So development of leaf lamina. In case, due to this growth, the tissues spread only in the superficial area. That means the cells arranged side by side. There is no increase in the row number. So there is no increase in the row number. That's why always epidermis is unicellular, because one kind of divisions takes place in one plane direction. So okay, that type of divisions are called as anticlinal divisions. So based on the divisions, meristems are three types. Last one is based on function. These meristematic tissues are meristematic cells which gives different type of organs. Different type of permanent tissues. So based on its functions, Haberlan identified three type of meristems. One is protoderm, another one is ground meristem, third one is procambium. These are the three type of meristematic layers in the shoot apex and root apex, which gives particular layers in the tissue system. So first, protoderm. Protoderm is outermost meristematic layer, which by radical division forms the epidermal tissue in the stem and epiblema, or the Filiparous layer in root. In both root and stem, epidermis is derived from the protoderm. Protoderm is the outermost meristematic layer in the shoot apex of the root apex, which develops into epidermis. So, three primary meristems. One of the meristematic layer which gives protoderm which gives development of epidermis. Procambium, which gives rise to vascular tissues. Vascular tissues, that is nothing but xylem and phloem and cambium of vascular bundles. The vascular bundles are develops from the procambium region. This is called the procambium. Procambium, the middle layer that is consisting of vascular bundles. And fundamental or ground meristem. Fundamental or ground meristem, which develops hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, and medullary race and pith region. So the tissues like cortex, pith, and medullary race, which are develops from the fundamental or ground meristems, occurs in between protoderm and procambium. It forms cortex, pith, and medullary region. So this yellow color part, which gives cortex region, and medullary race, hypodermis. This light blue color indicates that epidermis. That procambium, which gives vascular bundles composed with vascular cambium and xylem phloem. So these are the three type of meristems according to its functions. They are classified into three types. So these are the various type of meristematic tissues we have discussed. So in the next class, go through another topic, that is permanent tissues. Thank you, one and all.